ladies and gentlemen. With that, it is time for us to kickstart off the summit with a brand where, you know, whose mere mention is likely to bring a smile to consumers' faces because of the brand's multiple campaigns. I'm sure all of us remember the iconic 1990s Kuch baat hai, zindagi mein kuch khaas hai, hum tum sabhi mein campaign, which the brand successfully recreated in 2021. Also, don't forget the Meethe mein kuch meetha ho jaye campaign, and the brand continues to strike the right chord with the consumers, or as they may remind us, ki asli swaad zindagi ka actually kya hai. Well, taking us down the nostalgia trip is our keynote speaker, Deepak Iyer, President India, Mondelez Foods, who talks about the Cadbury Dairy Milk Journey, building one of India's most trusted brands. Well, with this, it is time for me to call upon the iconic Mr. Deepak Iyer. Thank you so much for your valuable time, and it's great to have you, and biggest smiles to welcome you. Over to you, and it's great to have you today. How are you doing today?
Very well. Thank you so much, Varma. And hello and good afternoon, friends. And thank you, Anurag and team, for having me speak at the Pitch CMO Summit. It's my pleasure and honor to be speaking at this August gathering. And of course, I'll be speaking on the theme of the summit, that's building brand trust. And of course, I will talk about the journey of Cadbury Dairy Milk, which Bhavna very fondly referred to in building brand trust. And I will speak with, and whenever I say CDM, it means Cadbury Dairy Milk. This, we are so used to using this word CDM instead of using a full phrase. I just thought I'll say that because whenever we talk about the brand, we have so much of passion around the brand, and it's always referred to as CDM. So can I have the presentation, please?
Sure. Could the team please roll out the presentation? Thank you. Over to you.
Thank you so much, Anna. The next slide, please. Yeah, as most of you were, might know, CDM was voted the number one trusted brand in India by Brand Equity in 2020 in their most trusted brand survey. See, it was number one, not just among snacking brands or chocolate brands or FMCG brands. It was number one across all categories of brands and all brands in this country. And I will talk today on what it took for CDM to get there. Can I have the next slide, please? So talking about trust, you know, without getting lost in a very convoluted or esoteric definition of trust, let me simply define trust in any relationship as a consistent and reliable connection, which is normally built over time. This is very much like how we build trust in our personal lives with our family, our colleagues, or our friends, right? The next slide, please. Now, this brings me on to saying, how did CDM or Cadbury Dairy Milk do it over the years? See, at Mondelez, we attribute it to four sets of reasons. One, having a meaningful connection with the consumer. Two, being consistent over time. Three, always being there, always engaging. And four, not just telling stories, but doing something about it. We call that story doing versus storytelling. Now, I don't mean to say storytelling is not important. So don't get me wrong, it's important. But to take the brand trust to the next level, the brand needs to do something more. It needs to do something about the story it is telling. And in CDM's case, the story is always about generosity. So I'll talk about each of these four points, and that will be the core of the content of my chat today, right? So the next slide, please. Thank you. See, the starting point of building trust with consumers is to create a strong connection with them. Long ago in my childhood, and likely before many of the young folks in the audience today were even born, chocolates was something that your rich dad, you know, or your rich uncle bought for you as a gift from his last visit overseas. Now, if we had left CDM as such without localizing its appeal, we would never have made the connection with our consumers. We could never have built out CDM the way we have built it out today. CDM built a connection with all of us through Kuch Meetha Ho Jaye. Think of those four powerful words and what it means to us. It's in Hindi, our local language. It makes it Indian. It embodies Indianness. And most importantly, it resonates with any Indian who would say, what is the point of living in India if you can't say Kuch Meetha Ho Jaye, correct? So that's the power of the connection. This is how CDM made a connection with consumers in India. It firmly made a Western category to be seen as a modern addition to the wonderful assortment of mithai and sweets that we so much relish, right? And the important thing here is that CDM never chose to compete with Indian sweets, which is what we so much love, right? It rather chose to blend with them. Now, when I say blend with them, think about integrating with them, right? So think chocolate modak, think chocolate sandesh, etc., right? Which are all chocolate-flavored sweets, which we so much relish. So once again, CDM made a connection with Indian consumers, right? I hope you're getting the point of connections that I'm talking about, right? See, another very important point on making connections is how many consumers are you able to connect with? How many consumers are you talking to? And on how many occasions? So long ago, chocolates were for kids. But like Bhavna said, with the iconic 1994 commercial, the Shimona ad, as you popularly call it, right? The lady dancing out of the cricket stadium into the cricket field, right? CDM made a connection with adults. So it enrolled adults. It made connections with expanded the connections beyond the kids to the adults, right? Again, CDM made connections, not just with the number of cohorts, but also with various occasions, right? So let's say it made connections with every part of the consumer's life. Now, let me recall some CDM ads. Let me recall some Cadbury Dairy Milk ads, right? Think of Pehli Tarikh ad and the connection it made with consumers then. Recall the Pappu Paas Ho Gaya ad. Think of Khane Ke Baad ad. Think of Shubharam. Think of the Rakhi ads. Think of the Diwali ads. Think of the Valentine ads, right? Today, every occasion worthy of sweets is accessible to CDM. Whether it's daily snacking or celebrations or festivities or gifting. And hence, CDM built category relevance for chocolates and made chocolates a part of the consumer's life, right? And that's what I want to talk about. How you make connections, how many cohorts did you connect with, and on how many occasions, right? And there's one more point I would like to make about connections, right? You might have noticed the CDM ads, they never made the brand the hero. It was always, kuch khaas hai hum sabhi mein, not Cadbury mein. Kuch khaas hai zindagi mein, not Cadbury mein. Kuch meetha ho jaye, not kuch Cadbury ho jaye. This is another very important way CDM connected very, very humbly with consumers and customers, right? Now, CDM became the fabric of the nation. It represents the taste of chocolate. Today, it stands for the modern progressive India. And that's a great story on how you make connections, right? Next slide, please. So the second chapter on brand trust is the notion of quality and consistency, correct? Now, both the product and proposition. So at the core of this is how we have kept the CDM product quality and experience sacrosanct. The product recipe remains the same over the years, despite living in an inflationary environment in India, which we have been living for the last 70 years that we have had the brand in India, 70 plus years. We have resisted all temptations to value engineer the recipe. Productivity is important for businesses, but we don't fiddle with the quality of the product. Like one of my colleagues mentioned it to me, we do qualitivity and not productivity. It's a very nice frame it's a nice way to frame the dual importance of quality and productivity, correct? Now let me talk about consistency. We call it fresh consistency. Our proposition, our message has evolved over time, but only within the bounds of Kuch Meetha. Our consumer work gave us deep insights on how we could leverage Meetha to tell inspiring Meetha stories over the years. Different manifestations, but around the core of Kuch Meetha. Despite getting to 20 years of the tagline, Kuch Meetha Ho Jaye is still fresh and it remains our sign off till today. Now, very often we see new brand managers or new client servicing managers wanting to do something different and wanting to make a difference and wanting to leave a mark or leave a legacy. And in this zest, they begin tinkering with propositions and messages, right? Now, we have ensured that this doesn't happen because we believe in being consistent. And we believe in strengthening our brand's distinctive memory asset. As we all know, marketers get bored of their own work much faster than consumers get bored of their work, right? So it's very tempting to go and change something there, right? So in summary, today, when any Indian consumer picks up a bar of CDM, she or he can be assured of the same great taste that they grew up on. When she or he sees a CDM ad, they can feel the same joy, the same warmth, the same spirit of giving, the same spirit of generosity, the same tagline that they're used to. And this is what we call consistency. Now, let me caveat this. It is not that we have not made any mistakes. We have. For example, a few years ago, we played the Martians ad. It is a nice ad, but it's not in the genre of the brand, right? So, but however, we were sensible enough to realize a mistake and correct it. So I'm not saying we have played a perfect act. It is just that we have tried to do it consistently. And whenever we have made mistakes, we say, okay, we have made a mistake. Let's correct it. Let's recoil it and see how we can put the right thing out there, right? So that's what I have to say on consistency. Next slide, please. Now, having built strong connections and having remained quality obsessed and delivered consistent messaging, the other important role in building trust is to always be there for the consumer. Having a point of view on what is happening around us, being present in the new mediums and touch points of the consumers are of equal importance. Hence, being present on digital and social media, speaking the language of Gen Z consumers is just as important as it is to be aspirational and relevant to a rural household on the other side, right? So as context changes with time, staying relevant as a brand becomes challenging. Hence, brand need to evolve to stay relevant to the consumer's new context. Now, creating platforms like Valentine's Day, Friendship Day have been critical as these occasions have become very important for consumers and they didn't exist 20, 30 years ago. These are not typical Meetha occasions, but we have created this and today they have become so important in our consumers' lives, right? Now, having a point of view on matters like diversity has become very relevant today. And CDM's work on the retake of the iconic Shimona ad, right, celebrating the outstanding prowess of our sportswomen, resonated very, very well with the consumers. Even other examples, like, you know, the Unity bar, the four different chocolates in one bar embodies the unity that we have amongst diversity in this country, right? The propaganda against cyberbullying, a purple hat campaign, right? The saying thank you to COVID workers, and I'll talk more about that a little later. When we changed the logo on our packs and we called it the thank you bar, all these have assured our consumers that we do have a point of view on what is important for our culture and what's important for our society. So you've always been there and you've always been engaging. And that's the point I want to leave behind with you on this slide. The next slide, please. Finally, trust is built when consumers realize that brands exist, not just for themselves and their profits, but for making a difference. Now, making a difference to the society is a very deeply rooted value in CDM's persona, right? For CDM, it is about generosity. It's a value that the Cadbury family espoused ever since they set up the company. And it now translates as the brand purpose across the globe. In India, we call it Kuch Achcha Ho Jaaye. Over the past years, we have built on it and done work, which has really stood out in a way that the brand highlights challenges around us and how the brand and the consumer can come together to solve it, right? So we launched a thank you bar as a salute to our COVID workers in 2020 because we felt what the whole nation was feeling, which was being grateful to them for working selflessly to protect our health and well-being. We created not just a Cadbury ad in Diwali 2020 and followed up with the second version last Diwali because we realized that small retailers were losing out on business and needed all the help they could get. On other occasions, we stood for unity, like talked about the Unity Bar. We stood against cyberbullying. And many such activations where the brand was focused on making an impact on people's lives. This is what we call story doing and not just storytelling, which means working with the consumers to espouse simple acts of generosity versus just talking about it, right? Now, another important set of points that I would like to call out here are that CDM never provoked any controversy. It was not about the brand wanting the limelight. It was always about a real consumer or a social issue. CDM's acts of generosity were consistent to what the brand stood for. And hence the brand was not seen to be exploiting the situation in its engagements. After all, if CDM doesn't stand up for Kuch Achcha Ho Jaaye, then who will, right? Now I will end with another point that I made at the start. Brand trust is built over time. And very often we see marketing ecosystems of brand managers or agency partners wrongly aspire to achieve this in a single year or the single campaign. No creative is breakthrough enough. No celebrity is large enough to build this trust overnight. Our learning is that it takes time and hence it's important for generations of brand managers to pass the baton to the new generation, to first hold the baton and not drop it. Think of one's role as, you know, think of one's role as getting and passing the baton of the brand from one generation of the brand team to the other generation while holding close, the core of the brand. In the period that we wrote, that we hold our roles, we must focus on deeply understanding our brands and build on its legacy while writing a chapter in the book of the brand story. That's the way you create legacy, and not by writing a new book. You know, so this entire thing about trying to do it overnight doesn't work. Think of it that this, for 70 years, so many brand managers have worked on this brand, right? Everybody handed over the baton to the other, and the other person took that baton instead of dropping it and trying to run a different race, right? It is not a 100 meter sprint, right? This is a relay race. It's run by different brand managers, different leaders over years. But they need to write their own chapters, but in the brand's book. They cannot write their own book on the brand. Right? Now, friends, that's what I had to say on CDM's journey on building brand trust. A meaningful connection with consumers, consistent product and propositions over time, always there, always engaging consumers, and not just storytelling, but also story doing. Anyway, now up kuch Meetha ho jaye, Anurag and the E4M team. Thank you.
Well, what a fabulous, hearing this was, Mr. Iyer. I have to say that definitely brought the biggest of smile. And as we always say, that this brand definitely has the connect with the consumers. So a lot of questions have been coming in, but of course, we would like to appreciate your time. So we are going to go and give ahead only 10 minutes to the Q&A, looking at your schedule. Would that be okay, Mr. Iyer?
Perfectly fine. Please go ahead.
Okay, perfect. So first, one of the questions is from Jayan Bose, who asked that your view on measurement techniques for measuring subconscious response leading to brand loyalty and how senses impact brand choice and loyalty. So what's your view on the measurement techniques for measuring subconscious response?
So quite honestly, Bhavna, so Jayant as well, I'm not an expert on this domain, so I don't think I'm in the best position to answer this. What I still do know is that things are evolving. Right? So today, the way you used to measure, let's say, people's feelings or responses or the subconscious was very different 10 years ago. And the way digital progress is happening today, there's a lot more that's happening, right? The way image processing is progressing with leaps and bounds, I think this is an evolving area. So the way I would like to summarize an answer, I really don't know exactly. That's not my area of expertise. But what I do know is that the old is changing for new ways, and data and digital is coming up in a very, very big way. So also machine learning, AI, AR, VR, and all the technological advances that are happening.
Right, absolutely. Also, the brand has multiple memorable iconic campaigns. Of course, while introducing you, we mentioned a few. But we'd like to get a heads up from you as to what have been your favorites, something which is recalled in your entire journey. Could you give us a few tidbits on those as well?
Kuch khaas hai zindagi mein. I mean, Shimona's ad was easily the most iconic ad, right? It went down as the campaign of the century of the last century, right? So, I mean, it's iconic in that sense. So, easily one of the best campaigns, and head and shoulders above the rest. It's not that, and getting head and shoulders above the rest of the CDM ads is not an easy ask in itself, right? Every one of those ads, I mean, look at Papu Paso guy. Till today, people who have seen it then will recall Amitabh Bachchan and his inimitable style, right? So, or you recall all the recent ads, or even recall the Bharat ad. It was a wonderful ad between the mom-in-law and daughter-in-law, correct? So, I mean, how you bring out these Meetha stories has been the hallmark of CDM. The one that stands out for me, of course, is 1994 Shimona, or the retake in 2021.
Right. That's great to know. Also, of course, because of COVID, a lot of companies have gone digital. A lot of business transformations have happened. So Pallavi Shah asked that, how has your business adapted to the digital change and e-commerce adoption? Is there anything you'd like to contribute to that?
Absolutely. So I'm not really sure of the question, Pallavi. Are you talking digital and data in the holistic sense across businesses or in the sphere of marketing and e-commerce? I'm presuming you're saying overall business, right? Now, see, digital and tech and data was always there. COVID just gave it a huge flip, almost sort of exponentially raised the importance of these things. It's gone up dramatically. Today is touching every aspect of a field. And let me give you a few very quick examples, right? So let's talk marketing. Technology today allows you to personalize at scale. Whereas television, you could just give one message to every audience, right?
Right.
Digital allows you to make it a two-way interaction, right? And hence, how do you bring that out? So we had 96,000 versions of a digital ad on Fuse because what a hunger meant at 4 p.m. to a girl traveling in the metro, college girl traveling back home from the metro, was very different from what a hunger meant for, let's say, a person who was working in the fields and coming back from the fields at 6 p.m. in the rural market, right? So you could do that personalizing at scale. The second big thing is, you know, the two-way communication. So once you start getting to know the consumers, right, it is not just about talking to them, but it's also about hearing them and seeing the responses, etc. So those are two big advances in marketing. You look at sales. Today, we use big data. Right. We use artificial intelligence. We use machine learning. We use AR, VR for design of POS materials. So it's actually touching every aspect of sales. In manufacturing as well, you know, the two examples I continuously give is that long time back, around 4 or 5 years back, we started putting sensors in all our machines in one of our factories, Sri City. And what the sensors used to do, we would get all the vital statistics of the line on a laptop screen. Now happened lockdown 1.0. All the operators were staying in the same district. They were on the floor in the factory, but the supervisor was in the next district and he couldn't travel. Right? And he couldn't travel for 3 weeks. For 3 weeks, he ran the line from his home and his laptop. This could have been impossible without technology, correct? So the smart factories, as we keep hearing, industry 4.0 is not something for the books. It's actually real and it's happening all around us.
Right. A great, great adoption right there. You know, there's a question coming from Deepthi, and, you know, we always talk about young marketers. So, you know, she would like an advice to young marketers such as her starting out. So Deepthi would love to hear from you as a piece of advice to the young marketers out there.
I mean, the advice is pretty much similar to almost everybody, right? So, and surely for young marketers, invest in learning. Today, the world is changing so rapidly. You can't say I learned it all from college or learned it all from my first job or my first assignment, right? It's changing. Right. Today, I'm now possibly 30 years in this industry, right? So, in the professional world, right? Or in the corporate jungle, as you may call it, right? But I'm still learning. I didn't know anything about AI or machine learning 5 years ago. I didn't know what would be the use cases of AR and VR. But today, unless and until I change myself, you know, it's impossible. I keep telling this very nice example to most of the people I talk about. Very often we read these news clips, right? Technology, AI, machine learning is going to eat up jobs. Hmm. And you always think it is the job of that plumber or the carpenter or, you know, somebody else. No, their jobs will stay because there's a physicality to those jobs. The names on that list whose jobs will go away are yours and mine. And unless and until we invest to learn and change, right, it won't. So my one simple advice, if I were to give you, of course, I could give you many more, is to stay invested in learning.
Invest in learning, absolutely. You know, Amog Agarwal asked that celebrity endorsements. So let's indulge into that arena. You know, celebrity endorsements varies from brand to brand. And, you know, one brand ambassador does multiple brand campaigns. So do you feel that this would impact the brand dilution in some sense? You know, when you are looking at it, how does you and your entire team decide? So that's what Amog is trying to ask to you, Mr. Iyer.
It's contextual, right? So there is a brand who has a persona. Right. And there is a celebrity who has a persona. The best way is the brand persona and the celebrity persona have a fitment of what they stand for, the values, the way the consumers see them, right? And that's when you get a multiplier effect, because what the persona brings, or let's say what the celebrity brings to you, is breaking the clutter. So when you're looking at a television with so many ads, right, you stand up when you have a big celebrity there doing an ad, right? Because you like to see a celebrity and you like the ad, and many of them emote very well, right? And they help break the clutter. But if the genre of the message that celebrity is giving is very different from what the brand persona stands for, then it's not really going to resonate very well with the consumers, right? So a lot of it is about the brand, the persona of the celebrity, what message you're giving, and what context you're talking to the consumers. So all of that needs to come together.
Right, absolutely. You know, firstly, I have to say, Mr. Iyer, of course, we respect your time, but there are a lot of questions coming. We've got another 3 minutes only to go. So we'll go ahead with one of the other questions. Rohit Singh asked that, truly appreciate your personalized Diwali ad with Shah Rukh Khan. How does a brand ensure to maintain trust and legacy while they adapt newer ways of marketing and technology like AI, etc.? What would your take be on that?
See, actually, it's an enabler. AI and technology, look at this ad of Shah Rukh Khan. What is it made out of? It's made out of the good use of deep fakes.
Right.
So what we've used is artificial intelligence. So which is able to recreate how a Shah Rukh Khan would emote or talk or sound in different contexts, right? And so our technology can be a very, very big enabler. I don't think they're in conflict or dissonance. It's just that we need to understand how to use them and in the right way.
Right. No, and I have to say, I was a big fan of the ad because we saw so many adaptions to it. And, you know, the small businesses, of course, benefiting with it, that really helped. Just one final question in view of time, we're going to be going ahead. Sumit asked that, are you also looking to explore CTV medium as there have been a major shift from linear channel to cord cutting activity? A lot of technical questions also.
I didn't get this at all. Tell me, what are the words? Are you
looking to explore CTV medium? I'm apologetic if I am also not aware on certain terminologies from my side. If you want, maybe there could be a typo error. Would you like to skip that question and move towards a personalization one?
Okay, or maybe I don't know this word, so both of them could be true.
No, I'm apologetic. Even I wasn't really aware on that. But just your final closing thought, Mr. Iyer, because I know there are a lot of questions coming in and we cannot take them on directly to you right now in lieu of time. Just your closing thought before we wrap up your wonderful session today, Mr. Iyer.
Yeah, so I think, you know, brand trust today, especially after what's happened over the last 2 years for all of us in pandemic, you know, it's actually been elevated to a level which it was never before.
Right.
And that kind of levels, we have never seen a brand required to sort of, you know, perform at. And hence, it's become super challenging for many brands. But equally, it has been a blessing in disguise for other brands who always stood for some purpose, right? And today, what are the consumers doing? They're gravitating to brands with a purpose. They're gravitating to brands with a trust. They're gravitating to brands which have been consistent and have always been there for them. Those are the messages I gave today, right? So I would say building brand trust has become even more important today than ever before. Yeah, I think you have to invest in it. If you have a brand and you want that brand to live for long and you want it to be around and actually become stronger and stronger, the one area which you must invest, you can't run away from, is brand trust. I talked to you about our stories on brand trust and how building CM. There are many other stories which will be very different. Yeah, so I won't say just rely on the stories that or the themes that I gave you. Look around, there'll be even better ways and even more complementary ways to build it, depending on the genre of your brand, right? Now, if you have a very tongue-in-cheek kind of a brand, right, which has cutting-edge humor, wit, and repartee, right, you don't build it the way you have built this. But the fundamentals are still the same. You need to engage, you need to be there, you need to be consistent, you need to do some story doing, right? Those won't go away.
Right, absolutely. Thank you so much, Mr. Iyer. There's so much we've learned from your session. You know, they say that experience counts a lot, and whatever you spoke and the nuggets of wisdom you brought about on the screen have been truly invaluable. Thank you so much.
Pleasure is mine. Thank you so much, Bama. Thank you so much, Pitch Summit.
Thank you.